In this section, I'm going to show you how to take great pre- and post-operative photographs for plastic surgery. So let's begin. There are three areas that you need to evaluate. You can have, for example, the face, you can have the breast, or the body. In these areas, you're going to have to include different parts of your body on the frame of your picture. For the face and neck, you need to include your shoulders and all the way up to the top. For the breast, you need to include your chin down to your umbilicus. And for the body, you need to include your chin down to the feet if you can. Positioning, we're going to need at least four views, which is the front, the side, and the back. If we can get those, especially for body, that's great. For breast and face, it'll be great to have five views, the front, the oblique, and the side view. Those are for the face and the breast. You feel free to send us more views, for example, the front, obliques, sides, obliques, and back, if you are doing for the pictures for the body, for example. Now, there are some things that you need to follow. For example, have someone take the picture for you. Don't just try to take it as a selfie. Don't use the front-facing camera, because the pictures can reverse if you do that. And then have someone step away 3 or 4 feet and take the picture that way to include the areas that we have discussed. Another thing, a very important thing, is that you include the background that is smooth and same color. Not something that is very busy. Make sure that it's clean and we can see, you know, a contrast at the edge. I have a black shirt and it's a black background. That's not the greatest. It's better if the background was, for example, in the lighter color. So if you are a darker color skin, it's better to do it on the lighter color background. And the reverse, if you have a lighter color skin, it's better to do it in the darker color background. So we can actually accentuate the edges and we can have a better definition of the contour of your body. And finally, I think if you follow these steps, we're gonna get very consistent photos, so pre-op and post-op. Because remember, all we need to do is compare apples to apples. And if we have good pictures, we're gonna be able to have a good comparison. And one last thing. When you take the picture, make sure the pictures are leveled with your sight. Not to take it from the top or the bottom, because that changes the angles and allows us and creates confusion when we are comparing the pictures. So the best thing to do is, if you are the first time taking the picture, try to take it following all the recommendations. And when you're taking picture post-op, then try to see the pictures pre-op and try to mimic or replicate the same picture in a different, you know, with a different time. But, you know, in the same angles and the same clothing, and try to be consistent. And remember, if you're taking pictures of your breast for evaluation, there should be no bra. If you're taking pictures of your body, then you could have underwear, as long as the underwear doesn't cover the surgical sites. If you're going to be evaluating the buttocks for a BBL, then you can have like a bikini or a thong so we can see the areas. But, you know, try not to cover everything. Don't send us, you know, pictures with pants or so forth, because we can't see the surgical sites. I hope all these recommendations have been helpful for you. And when is the next time you're taking pictures, remember to follow all these guidelines. Enjoy, and always remember, believe in magic.